got to learn to say yes to what you believe in. Now, the problem with a lot of y'all in this room, you really don't know what you believe in. And it's time for you to find out what you believe in. I'm loyal. I'm not smart. I'm not intelligent. I'm loyal. And guess what? If I'm going to be successful, I got to stay loyal. That's a part of the brand. If you run and you start losing, you just don't just start throwing the ball. That's not your strength. You got to keep going with the run until it opens up. And most of you down in life right now, so you didn't switch your whole game up. You're just like, whoa. Can I teach you? ET, I don't know about sports. I just want to teach you something. The great quarterbacks. I have nothing against the runners. I'm not into the dudes that run. Nothing against the runners. But what you know about football is when you line up with that center and you say hike and you boom, I don't know if you three-step, you five-step, right? But when the pressure comes, the pressure don't usually come straight ahead. The pressure usually come around. And guess what happened when you run? You're running into it. What you need to learn how to do, the greats that can't run. That's why the quarterbacks that can't run are usually good, because they don't have that option, right? So you know what they do? They step into the pocket and they step into their protection. And that extra 2 steps and that extra 2 seconds is just what you need to get your wide receiver open, and then boom. And the problem with most of y'all, instead of you stepping into your belief system, every time something go wrong, you start running and doing what other people tell you to do. And what you need to learn how to do is you walk into your belief system. You gotta watch the QBs. When they step up here. They don't step up down here. They step up here, they boom, boom. And what we did was, when his wife said, I need you to get a job, he went and got a job as a substitute teacher. They was about to hire that boy full time. He called me. I was like, see, I know she gonna get you, but I need you to step into the pocket, see? You gotta step into the pocket, see? don't do me, see? Don't do it, see? She was like, I got you, E, but you gonna have to pray for me. I'm like, I got you, see? And he stepped into the pocket. And if you type in Google, Eric Thomas, we stepped into the pocket. Stop stepping out the pocket. And stop thinking every time something go wrong, you gotta surround yourself with people. You gotta start drinking stuff, smoking stuff. When you are alone, alone just means some time to think some stuff through. Stop filling the void with junk. Stop filling the void with junk. And just step into the pocket and give it some time. You're going to be all right. I've been doing this for over 20-some years. It didn't happen the first 10 years. Give yourself some time. You're going to be all right. So what Dan Gilbert does that I love is he has 19 isms, and that training is about going over every 19.
Success in any fucking thing. Success requires obsession. I can't say it enough. You must be obsessed. But to obtain success, you must fucking be obsessed with that. There's no way around it. The fucking best at anything must be obsessed. If you're a fucking pancake flipping motherfucker, then you must be obsessed with being the best pancake flipping motherfucker. If you park fucking cars, you gotta be obsessed with being the best parked car and motherfucker. Whatever the fuck you do, you cut grass and you the best mowing motherfucker around. But you got to be obsessed with that. What does it mean to be obsessed? Dream that shit. Eat that shit. Sleep that shit. Breathe it, motherfucker. Breathe that shit. Inhale that shit. That shit is coursing through your fucking veins. That shit makes your skin crawl. That shit. You can't live without that fucking shit. I can taste that fucking shit. That's what it means, motherfucker. You daydream about that shit. Everything that you do is aimed toward hitting your goal, reaching your goal in that shit. Whatever that shit is. Whatever it is, motherfucker. Be obsessed. Be obsessed with that shit. On the point, he fucking said, is that motherfucker crazy? Yeah, if obsessed with being crazy, yeah, motherfucker. I'm crazy. Yeah. I'm off. Yes. I'm one. one motherfucking sentence away from a fucking straitjacket. Yeah, I'm upset. I'm not ready yet. I'm not ready to let you take over. I'm not gonna let you take over a motherfucking thing. How about that? CT, how about we have a duel? CT, how about I challenge you? How about this? How about it, motherfucker? I'm not ready to let you take over. I'm gonna fight you with every fucking thing I got. And you may see a few gray hairs, you may see a few wrinkles here and there, motherfucker, but don't let that shit fool you. I'm still rule of the motherfucking roots, motherfucker. I'm still the sidewalk cracking motherfucker from Compton. I'm still the master. I am still the one, motherfucker. The one that you heard about. The one there's rumors about. Down through the ages, down through the years, there's one coming, and he shall be the greatest. I am still that motherfucking one. Success in any fucking thing. Success requires obsession. I can't say it enough. You must be obsessed. But to obtain success, you must fucking be obsessed with that. There's no way around it. The fucking best at anything must be obsessed. If you a fucking pancake flipping motherfucker, then you must be
obsessed with improvement. Be obsessed with improvement. And like the lion, go from a gazelle to a lion. Why? Because if you don't kill it, then your family won't eat. That's my child. I want you to focus on here right now. Don't you worry about when you get home. You make this, you concentrate on this opportunity. You don't worry about tomorrow. You concentrate on this opportunity with all your might, with all your soul, with all your heart. You focus on this, and tomorrow will take care of itself. Oh, I promise you that. So on three because I believe. One, two, three. So I need you to say it like you mean it. One, two, three. All right, now I need them to hear you outside. One, two, three, because I believe. All right, come on, give yourselves a hand. Woo! PhD. Why? Because I've been telling the world I'm going to get that PhD. And so now it's getting to a point when I say it, it sounds like I'm not an executor. At the end of this weekend, I promise that I will become an executor.
I got it!
I don't have to be number one, but I want to wake up every day and chase the dude that's number one. I want to stay on his trail, on his tracks. I need something to keep me moving, keep me going. Okay, I want you to catch the spirit of that. I don't have to be number one. Guess what? I grind and I took off for an entire year. I didn't speak as much as I used to. And I got the last two classes I needed to do. I start writing and writing and writing. And I wake up at 3 o'clock, have my prayer.